Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Now, once we recognize that valence electrons are important, we need to be able to count how many valence electrons each atom has. Now, fortunately, doing this is easy as looking at a periodic table. And our problem is made even simpler by the fact that organic chemistry, you typically only encounter 10 common elements. So in the upper left, what are these 10 common elements that we'll encounter a lot? Well, the first is hydrogen. And then moving down to the second row, atoms we will see covalently bound in our molecules include carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. Those are all in the second period or second row. Third row elements, phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine. And then from the fourth and fifth row, we'll pull in the two halogens, bromine and iodine. So these are the only ones that we really need to focus on with regularity. And as it turns out, these are all what we call main group elements. And what is a group? Well, group refers to these column numbers that we see on the periodic table. So on this particular periodic table that I have, these are written in Roman numerals. So this is group one, there's group two, and then we skip some, and we get three, and it goes all the way to eight. Now, fortunately, our group number equals the number of valence electrons that we have. So hydrogen is in group one, therefore hydrogen has one valence electron. Carbon is in group four, therefore it has four valence electrons. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, all four of our halogens, they're in group seven, therefore they have seven valence electrons. Now, one word of warning. Not all periodic tables are labeled with the exact same group numbers. And this sounds terrible, but there's a simple fix for this. On the periodic table that we have, we only go 1 through 8. Often, and I'll show this at the bottom of the screen, people will start again with 1, 2, and then they'll include what they call the D block elements in their group number counting. So they'll go 3, and it goes all the way over here, picks up again at 13, 14, and then continues on 17 and 18. Well, now if you say, well, it's just the group number is the valence electrons, well, carbon now under this system is in group 14. Carbon only has 6 electrons, so it can't have 14 valence electrons. Well, what we do in this case, just chop off the tens place. So in our old system up the top, it was 4, now it's 14, chop out the tens place, and once again, we're back to 4 electrons. Same for the halogens, instead of 17, it's 7 electrons. So if we can look at a periodic table, we can very quickly figure out how many valence electrons a particular neutral atom will have.